Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, friends, family, and loved ones. We are very fortunate to have such a beautiful day upon us as we celebrate the union of Brian and Sam. We are here to celebrate the love of two incredible people that, before their friends and family, are committing to each other that love will always prevail. They are vowing that through all the highs that life has to offer, they will always demonstrate that same unconditional love during the lows.
This day is actually here. All my life I've been dreaming of the angel I was going to spend the rest of my life with. Little did I know I was always dreaming of you. I'm so incredibly lucky to be your husband. I love you so damn much. I'm 100% going to cry when I see you. Love, Brian.
Dear Dad, I believe the most important lessons in life I learned from you. Now that I'm older, I can really appreciate everything you do and everything you've told me. I can count on you for everything I need. Why do I
of Sam and Brian begins on the softball diamond, where Brian attempted to woo Sam with a .437 batting average. Pretty modest for slow pitch softball, but Sam fell for him nonetheless, and after countless amounts of slow dancing at all of the weddings attended of friends and family, one night, over chicken parm dinner, Brian decided to ask Sam to marry him. It was a culmination of these moments that helped define the love story of Sam and Brian. I have known Brian since high school, where we played lacrosse together and became friends. That friendship has remained strong through the years, and though I've only known Sam since the beginning of their relationship, in the opportunities that have presented themselves, she has proven to be a great friend. I truly am lucky to have her in my life. But to get where we are today, there of course is the journey, and the greatest part of falling in love is that journey. Love also means exercising forgiveness and compromise. Love is being willing to accept the fact that even though Brian just gave up his Lego collection, at any given moment he could start another one. Love is taking your wife down to the beach whenever she wants to go, because peak hours are peak hours, Brian, and getting this tan is not that easy. Love is letting someone sneak in a nap every once in a while, even if it's an hour before you're going to bed, or an hour after you wake up, or an hour before dinner, or during dinner. Okay, Brian, we all love naps, but maybe less naps. Brian, you've been a great friend to me, and I've seen you be a great friend to those around you. Totally selfless, and from the outside, I can see you've been a great son, brother, and uncle to your family. I can't wait to see what kind of husband you are to Sam, because the sky's the limit with you. And Sam, you're one of the hardest working people I know. I'm so happy Brian met you, and you guys are building this future together. I can't wait to see how far this goes.
Sam. good start, right? It's no secret, I am far from being perfect. If you ask my mom, she'll disagree. But if you ask my friends, well, I'll leave that up to your imagination. I've pinched myself every day for the last 3 years to confirm I was really this lucky to have you in my life. So I can assure you, I'm not dreaming. I promise to treat your family as they are my family. I promise to tell you I love you as often as I can. And when I tell you I love you, I don't say it out of habit. I say it to remind you that you are the best thing that has ever happened to me. Although my speech is over, my vows to you remain for the rest of my life.
Brian, love is putting someone else's happiness above your own. You do that with every decision you make. I want to vow to do the same for you, to love and support, to sacrifice without hesitation, care unconditionally, and bring out obnoxious laughs. I just want to give you this feeling I'm having right now, every day for the rest of our lives. I feel like a kid whenever we're together, mostly because your eating habits consist of dino nuggets and ice cream, but also because I've never laughed so hard, felt so carefree, or lived so full. I vow to keep feeling young as we grow old. I'm blessed with the continuing love and support of the people that are here today. It's a gift I cherish most, and I just want to share it all with you. When you put a label of forever on something, it can seem daunting and scary. But with forever with you just seems exciting. And when I picture our future together, I do nothing but smile. I love you.
Sam, Brian, you have heard the words of love, exchanged vows, and have made this union official with the exchanging of rings. Your friends and family are ready to celebrate with you as soon as we can get to that open bar. And I heard there's two. By the power vested in me, on behalf of the state of Pennsylvania, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride.
This could be the start of something really big that with some hard work and some faith and some love, the one thing I say is just leave enough time to be affectionate to each other. Here's to a lifetime of faith, hope, happiness, and love.
Of course, I always looked up to Sam, just wanting to follow her around, wearing her clothes, doing whatever she did. I can't thank you enough for the love and protection you've given me over the years. It's the most unconditional thing I've ever experienced in my life. Cheers.
Brian, over the years, I've been fortunate to see the best and worst of you, from what I can remember at least. You know, I've been told that being the oldest brother is kind of like being a father figure. You're supposed to pass down wisdom and knowledge from your life, much like Dad. I wish you the best of luck. I wish you many years of happiness. Here's to the newlyweds. Cheers.
I'm up here to wish you guys happiness and success in your marriage. At some point tonight, just step back, look at everyone in here, take a good look. We're all here to support you. We all love you.
There's an old saying about friendship that reads, it is one of the blessings of old friends that you can afford to be stupid with them. And goodness, that cannot be more true about me and Brian.
Sam, you look absolutely stunning. Bridesmaids, y'all look beautiful. And then there's Brian. It's still weird calling you Brian. You two are amazing for each other, and it's been so grateful to watch you grow from the beginning. Cheers to new Mr. and Mrs. Einstein.